First of all, how about a round of applause for the weather today? How about a round of applause for our participants for the 17th Artomobilia? Really fantastic weather, a great day, a turnout of over 518 cars, so really impressive, and just a nice day for the city. And to join me on stage, I'd like Mayor Sue Finkham to come on up and say a few words about your impressions of the day.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming to Carmel for this incredible event. 17 years, over 500 cars this year, and infinite amounts of fun and memories for all of us. So thank you for being here. If you haven't been to Carmel before and this is your first time, arts are in our DNA. And the artistic expression with the automobiles that are here, the performance focus, and community spirit that this event, you know, really supports is incredible. So we're glad to have you see this community and enjoy it for all that it is. I think we're gonna keep this temperature, this amount of cars and fun year in and year out, if that's okay with you.
That's perfect for me. Is this the kind of weather we could expect from the Finkham administration?
Yes, I'm pretty sure that was a campaign promise, yes.
You heard it here first, he controls the weather, I love that. Well, it's great to have you, thank you so much. This has been, the city supported, this is what makes it work. So thank you so much for being here today. All right, how about a round of applause for our mayor? All right, so we had a lot of paloozas this year. We had BMW, Porsche, Lotus. What else am I missing, guys? Mercedes. So I'd like Roger to come up and help me out with the Mercedes first. We'll bring the Mercedes up. If you guys watch yourselves, if you're in the parking lot, we do have cars on the move here. We'll have all the award winners come up. The first is a beautiful Mercedes. Roger's gonna tell us about it and the Monumental Award. Roger?
So this is a heritage car. Brandon Sorge is going to drive across the stage here with his son. He rolled this car off of the rack after, I believe, a two-year ground-up restoration on the car. So this is a 71 Pagoda SL. And Brandon, congratulations. This was an eye-popper the moment you drove it in here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Congratulations.
What color? I need to know the color.
Car?
Yeah.
Before this?
No, what is it now?
You know, I don't have it particularly right, so I can't give it to you correct.
We're keeping this a secret, everybody. There you go. Right. That's the Mercedes mentality. All right. Thank you, Roger. Thanks so much. Thank you for bringing out a wonderful car. Great. I love it. That's a father-son combo. Thank you. How about a round of applause? Next up, I'd like the Porsche guys to come up if they could. My representatives from Porsche. Please introduce yourselves. Aha. I even like the shirt. All right, a little bit about yourself and the award.
Okay, this award goes to, but there's a Lotus coming.
Oh, that's a Lotus. We'll put that inside.
Yeah.
Can you bring the Porsche up?
Bring the Porsche, please.
One second, I'm gonna have the Lotus guys come up. Young, if you can come up first, we'll what? All right, you're here, come on up. If you bring the Lotus up, please. Is this like a metaphor that Lotuses are ahead of Porsches? I don't wanna start anything right now, but okay.
Yes. Okay, don't hate. So Lotus cars, the Palooza, it's kind of grown over the years. But before I say anything about this car, can we give a round of applause to John Leonard and everybody that puts this thing together? They did a really good job. Thanks, guys. Appreciate you. It's the toughest thing to be a Lotus lover and then to judge a Lotus car. It's might as well make enemies and best friends at the same time, right? But every now and then you run across a car that makes no sense and you think that's not real. You look at this car, you see another Lotus Exige. But the truth is, it's the 2008 Lotus Exige, paint code B124. That means nothing to you guys, except the Le Mans Blue. They only made 17 of them for North America. And for us to actually see one, I thought, oh, somebody wrapped their car, put the black stripe on it, made it look like it. And then I checked the VIN, and I'm like, oh, wow, it's a real thing. So Nick Funson, we appreciate you bringing the car out here. And because of that, here is the best in group.
Thank you.
Thanks. Congrats.
Hold up, Nick. Don't pull away real quick. I just want to ask you a couple questions. So how did you come how did you come to get this car? It's such a rare car.
Oh, it was a local car that came available 7 years ago, and it's been a lot of fun ever since. We absolutely love it.
Looks like it's father-son thing too, which I love to see. Love the color. Thank you for bringing it out. The Lotus Club Racer, everybody. All right, can I have my BMW Palooza representatives, please? BMW. Stands for Bavarian Motor Works. There we go.
Hi, I'm Cash with the BMW Club, and we have 45 cars in our Palooza today. We picked John Coffin here with his 2000 E39 BMW M5. It has only 50,000 miles. We picked it because it is the original owner. John's had it since 1999 and has kept it in excellent original shape. Other than tires and oil change, it is essentially original. So John, here you go. Thank you.
Sedan with a stick shift, everybody. Represent. Nice car. Thank you for sharing it with us. I love those wheels. Those are legendary. All right, John Wu, would you please come back up? Because now we have the Porsche in line. John? John?
Hi, there are some mix-ups, but this year's winner goes to 1969 Porsche 912. So anybody knows about that 912 and 911 difference? It's okay, we don't have to know, but it's a pretty great car. So tell me about your car.
So the 1969 912 has been in the family for over 53 years. It just came back from an 8-year full restoration.
All right, so this goes to your truck. Thank you.
Thank you. Love the Fuchs wheels, by the way. Very nice. All right, now we're going to start with our awards. Oh, we have one other. We have a Porsche Restoration Award.
So one of the unique things about Artomobilia is we are constantly trying one more new thing every year, and this year we included Porsche North America in their Porsche Classic Restoration Challenge. Yesterday it was hosted at the Motor District. Go Motor District. They hosted 9 of the cars, and they were judged by some pretty fantastic judges. Not surprisingly, the 356 won. It was absolutely brilliant in every way. These guys did a great job, brought it all the way down from Minneapolis, right? Minneapolis. And the work speaks for itself. So this is a new thing that we're trying to institute. It's outside of the traditional Porsche Palooza, but as everybody knows, I'm a Porsche guy, so I'm always trying to get these guys involved. But anyway, congratulations, guys. Thank you for bringing such an absolutely stunning car. Here you are. Thanks so much.
Thank you, John Leonard. All right. All right, so this first award is going to be delivered in a little bit different way. We have our gentleman from Arrive over here. Let's watch the drone as it brings me the next award. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the future. This is how your packages are going to start showing up on the doorstep. They'll be flying in this way. This is a drone powered, this is a company based here in Carmel, Arrive, and you'll be getting your packages in the future. We have the box open. We're positioning. Latest in tech here at Artomobilia. Oh, look at that. Ladies and gentlemen, success! How about a round of applause? I'm going to ask our retiring head judge right here, give a round of applause to Dave Renshaw, by the way. Dave is handing the reins over. Dave, if you could please open the box and grab the award for me. Go around the back. Presto Changeo. Ta-da! All right. All right, first of all, this is beautiful. I noticed this earlier today. I love the color combo. You have to tell us about it. This is Lindsay Hahn, correct? All right, Lindsay, tell us about this. This is a 1965 factory Ford Cobra. Tell us about the car and the journey you've had with it.
It's a replica car. It's a factory five replica of a 65 Cobra. It's a kit car, so I assembled it myself. And it has a crate motor, a five-speed manual transmission, power steering, and a hydraulic clutch just to make it easy for me to drive.
Well, it's a beauty. Now, so what's it powered by? You said it's a crate motor. What kind?
Quarter-turn engine, 302.
Perfect for this. And this is about a 2200 power car with probably 400 horsepower? Only 300 horsepower with 2200 pounds. So that's some miles per mile. Do you have a throttle limiter in your right seat occasionally?
That's my trophy wife.
Well, you're going to get a trophy to go with her. There you go. Congratulations. Thank you for being here. This is beautiful. How about a round of applause for this beautiful Cobra? Congratulations. All right, up next. And this is heartwarming to me because this is actually a personal friend of our family. So this is Chris Price, AKA known as Shipmate to my brother. He lived next door to my brother for years, which is an enduring thing for him. But Shipmate is a former naval man, and I'm gonna let him tell you about his 1985 RX-7.
I bought this in California in 1994, and I've had it for 30 years, and I've never had a problem with it. That's it.
Chris, beautiful car, congratulations. And now if you know Shipmate and you know anybody who's a former Navy man, the attention to detail and the ability to polish and shine is here, and it's evident in this car. So how about a round of applause for Chris? Congratulations, thank you for bringing it out. Okay, this next one is, everybody know who Fat House Performance is? Raise your hand if you know who Fat House is. They build some of the biggest, baddest Mustangs and other cars on the planet. And this is actually personally owned by Ben Stoner, the owner of Fat House. Ben is not with us today. Ben is actually doing great service. He is attending the funeral, unfortunately, of Evan Meager. If you guys knew Evan, Evan was big in the Carmel community. We lost Evan a couple weeks ago. His service is actually this afternoon. But Ben said, I'm going to show my car. And we actually had Evan's car here during the day, and it's actually currently at the services. But a round of applause for Ben and the Fat House team for such a beautiful car. Ben bought this. It was a basket case at best. My good friend and Mustang aficionado said, yes, I'll drive that for you. I was actually going to have to run out, drive it, back it up. But we want to be efficient here. So winning Muscle and Pony 2 is Benjamin Stoner of Fat House Fabrications. We'll make sure we get that to Ben. You can't hear me over the cam, I have a feeling. Thank you. All right, next up, we have the machine. And if you knew AMC back in the day, this is owned, I'm going to ask you the name. Is this Paul?
No, Chris.
Chris. This is Chris Hutchins in a 1970 AMC Rebel Machine winning Muscle and Pony number one. Tell us a little bit about this and your journey with the car, sir.
Yeah, it's a 1970 AMC Rebel Machine. I've had it probably about 3 years now, and I've pretty much done a body-on restoration on it.
Well, it's beautiful, and I love the hood tack. That's sweet. And what is this powered by?
390.
390, and it's got the nice rumply rump. All right, and here, sir, is your best-in-class Muscle and Pony 1. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And I'd love to see your kids with you.
Thank you.
All right. Up next in the classic car category, a 1936, I love the old school iron, an Auburn Salon 852 Phaeton. This man not only has the car, he's got the panache to go with it, and I like that lid. Everybody meet Hal Ames. Hal, tell us about the car.
My grandfather helped to design this car, so there's a little family connection to it. Had it about 6 months, and I've shown it a lot, and I continue to let people see it.
That's the best part of it. Thank you for sharing it with us. It's great, and what a cool family part of the history this. Your dad helped design part of this. Grandfather. Well, it is beautiful, and anybody who knows the Auburn Ford Duesenberg Museum is one of the best. If you haven't visited, I highly recommend. It's one of the better drives in Indiana to get up there and go see all the beautiful cars. Thank you. Round of applause. Thank you. Oh. Come on up. Good to see you. All right, tell us about this beautiful machine.
Yeah, so it's a 67 Jaguar E-Type, willow green over beige interior, numbers matching car, original color combination, full rotisserie restoration, nut and bolt. The car just finished. It has about, well, whatever the mileage is from getting to the trailer to here.
Six miles.
So, yeah. Restored by Muncie Imports and Classics from Muncie, Indiana.
Well, thank you for bringing it out. It is a testament. And if you guys know the story, Enzo Ferrari supposedly is being quoted and saying that the most beautiful car he's ever seen was a Jaguar E-Type. And that comes from the head of Ferrari. So thank you very much. Let's give you your trophy. Why don't you go ahead and take that? Thank you. Well done, gentlemen. All right, next up. Ooh, I like this. ESC1 category. This is European sports cars. This is Don Tharp. Oh, it's not Don Tharp. Yep, 38 Jag.
No.
Nope. Is this Brandon?
No.
Just come on up and we'll talk. This is the ESC1, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You got it?
Yep. All right, this may take a few minutes, so you have to reach across the car.
So this is a 1938 Jaguar SS100. My father owns the car, he's back there, and it's been in the family for about 40 years. Yeah, this is father, son, grandson. Bought it in 1982, I think, is what he said. So, 42 years now.
Well, first of all, it's beautiful. The color's amazing. I love that you have the detail kit in the back and extra gasoline. The wire wheels are just amazing. And you are the winner in this class. Congratulations. And I love the three generations of family. Young man, take that and give that to your grandfather for me. All right. Thank you. That car will also be competing for Best in Show, just so we know. It'll be back up again.
ESC2.
All right, we have a 1987 Mercedes-Benz 190E 2.3 owned by Sam Zimmerman. Sam, tell us a little bit about the car. Love the look.
Oh, thank you very much. This is a car I saw in a gas station in 87, figured how do people afford a car like that? I gotta work a little harder. And just waited for time to catch up. Found it in Dayton and I've had it for about 6 years, and it's a work of love.
It is a work of love, and it's also part one of the best stylings I think ever came from Mercedes-Benz as far as their sedan class. And it is a stick shift, ladies and gentlemen, and a sedan. You gotta like that. Represent. Thank you so much, Sam. Hold on, I'm gonna hand you a trophy. Thank you. Display that with pride. You've earned it. This is EC1. This is Dave Mueller with an Austin Healey Bug-Eyed Sprite. Love this car. These are so cool. All right, tell us a little bit about your journey with this car.
Thank you. 1959 Austin Healey Bug-Eyed Sprite. I found it 17 years ago in San Diego. Very clean out there. I'd always told my wife, Mary Beth, that if I ever saw one, I'm going to bring it home. Because I was 17 years old when I had my first one, and it took that long to find this one. I really enjoy it. This is my seventh Artomobilia, and thank you for your help.
Well, thanks for bringing it out and showing us. This is a piece of history, ladies and gentlemen. I love your personal story. My wife and I have several car discussions every now and then. Some of them are not in my favor. I like to refer to my wife as the Finance and Approval Committee. This is ESC1. This is Don Tharp. There we go. We got the right people this time. And you got your trail buddy with you. I like it.
Yeah.
All right. How are you doing? You used to have a Corvette too, didn't you?
I've been here three times.
You've been here three times. And what did you win with?
I won with a 54 Corvette, a 52 Nash Healey, and this is a 53 Coupe Nash Healey with a V8.
I like your style.
One of four V8s that were done at the factory. This is a 327 made by AMC, which was the before Chevrolet.
Really? Fantastic. Well, it's a beautiful car, and it's just absolutely straight as an arrow. The body looks phenomenal. Who did the restoration?
Restoration in Florida. I just forgot this city.
That's okay.
San Diego.
Sarasota. You're going with Sarasota. Well, it's a beautiful car, Don. Thank you so much for bringing it out, and I'm glad that you came along.
Four years.
I'm going to let him. You want to take that? All right. The handoff. Okay. Thank you. Three-time winner. But different cars. And a plate to match, 53 Nash. I like that a lot. The American sports car category, 1974 to present, the winner, Jason Creighton, in a beautiful 2005 Dodge Viper SRT10, the Mamba edition, I'm told. Is that correct?
That's correct.
The Mamba. The good news, you don't have to do a Mamba to get your trophy, but you have to tell us about the car. My buddy Mark Young was like, so what's your favorite car in the show? Yes, that Silver Viper.
Oh, thank you. Well, thank you. That's awesome. Yeah, it's a 05 Viper SRT10. It's a Mamba edition, meaning it's got a special package. It's number 90 of only 200 that they made. And if you see a Mamba, it's either going to be silver, white, or black. That's the only difference that they made. The car has never been outside the family, and if I have anything to say about it, never will.
That's fantastic. And Vipers are some of the most dangerous supercars to drive because V10 horsepower, a lot of torque, and no driver assist. So it is you and your will. So the fact that this thing is still straight and shining, either you have a modulated throttle or a brick between you and the floor, or you're a damn good driver. Which one is it?
I like to think the third one.
Okay, the third one. We're going with the third. And a solid co-pilot. All right. Thank you for bringing it out today.
Thank
Round
you.
Of applause, please. Custom vehicles. Oh, Slammy-O. I always love this year of truck from Chevrolet. This is a 58 and 59, so good looking. Oh my goodness, and a horn. Wow, that didn't wake you up. So we're about to hear about this car, and this thing is, I love it when it drops. Drop it like it's hot. Okay, so. Ron?
Yes, sir.
Tell us about it.
We had a truck built by this builder out of Hudson, Iowa, in the probably around 2020, and we sold it, and he wanted to build a Cameo. This is the rarest Chevrolet truck ever built in 105 years. The fiberglass bed on these were built at the Corvette plant. This is the first vehicle truck since 55 that had a smooth side. Chevrolet wanted to be the first. And then it was built for the SEMA show out in Las Vegas. It had the largest displacement power-wise, 650 horsepower supercharged crate engine by Chevrolet. So a rare Chevy truck with this power plant, and it won the GM Performance Design Award out in Las Vegas. And I drove 300 and some miles to get here, had the crew set on 85 and kicking the tunes through the rain yesterday. And just, I drive it. It's got 25,000 miles on it since we built it, and I just have fun with it.
That deserves a round of applause right there. So thank you so much. It's one of my favorite vehicles on the planet. Thank you for bringing it. Thanks for the, I love it as a driver. And I'm going to hand you this beautiful piece of hardware. Thank you, sir. Slamio, how many people have been to SEMA? So I want you to know that this year, Carmel was represented very well in SEMA by the family, Russell and Kevin Cameron, who live up here just north of 146th Street. And they took a beautiful car called Hammerhead that I actually had the chance to help work on. In fact, it was on the cover of Hot Rod, and it was a sensation. It was actually currently today at LS Fest, and the day before, it was at the Triple Crown of Hot Rodding. So it's really making the rounds. We hope to have it here next year at Artomobilia. That's Hammerhead. But in front of me, I have a large automobile with a lot of metal, and this thing probably takes forever to clean. This is Joe Alberts with his 1954 Cadillac Eldorado. Mr. Alberts, please tell me more about this beautiful ride.
Well, it's a 1954 Eldorado Special Sport. It's mostly original, a numbers matching engine, and we try to keep it as original as we can.
It's so cool and so sweet, and it is exactly what this era was about. And I love the color combo. Was this the original color combo?
Original color combo.
Wow. And the steering wheel looks legit. I mean, all the interior accoutrements, and I'm sure the chrome bill on this thing is not cheap.
It takes a while to polish.
Let's hope we don't have to re-chrome anything anytime soon, because you'll have to cash a savings bond. All right. Our winner in best in class American car, AC1. Thank you so much. I know what this is. This is a Cyclone. Does anybody know what the SUV counterpart was to the Cyclone? I heard Typhoon. You, sir, are a winner. You get an extra free beer from our friends at Beer afterwards. Just tell them I sent you. In the truck category, all years, this is Robin Miles in a 1991 GMC Cyclone. And I saw this gentleman earlier. He actually has a shirt to match his truck. It's like, is that like wearing the concert t-shirt to the concert? Is that allowed? I didn't know.
I just got the strange accent too.
Well, tell us where you're from.
So I'm originally from London, but I live in Westfield right now. So yeah, this is a fun little machine.
And how did you come to find this?
So it's one of 2,900 built. I found this in Maryland, second owner. It's done 37,000 miles from new. And it's a hell of a lot of fun.
So just so you know, this is a turbocharged V6 with all-wheel drive, and it was actually faster than the Corvettes at the time.
0-60 in 4.3 seconds, 13.3 quarter mile.
And that was hauling back in the day, my friends. That's when Mustangs were turning 14.5s or like 15. So beautiful car. Thank you for sharing it, and I'm glad you came out today. Is this your first time at the show?
Yeah, it is. And thanks to everybody that organized this. You guys did a fantastic job. Really amazing.
It takes a village, and thanks to all our volunteers here. Thank you, and the judging team. How about a round of applause for them and this beautiful Cyclone? Okay, in the preservation excellence category, this is a 1965 Ford Mustang race car, owned by Tony Santonastas. Did I get it right? How about that? Years of announcing swim meets with names I didn't know. I'm pretty good on the uptake. All right, Tony, tell us about this really nice looking Mustang.
Thanks. I hand you over to my co-owner.
This car was raced from 1968 to 1980 with SCCA San Francisco region. So Don Napolitano and Jan Green drove it back with all of the other manufacturing teams in the day. And it was brought back to life, and now we're stewarding it well.
and good stewards you are. If you also saw a beautiful Brittany Blue 67 Mustang, it was a tribute to a girl by the name of Mallory Hook, owned by Stephen Moore, owner of Chateau Kitchens here. Another beautiful Mustang. We lost Mallory, unfortunately, to leukemia, so it was great that that car was finished in time. But this thing is a correct piece, a period piece, and you guys are great keepers of the flame, so thank you very much for doing that. All right, enjoy. All right, our Historical Excellence Award goes to Paul Amone in a 1972 Mercury Cougar XR7. You talk about class pulling up back in the day. The Mercury Cougar was about it. I love the Landau top, too.
That's the best part of the car.
That's the best part of the car? Yeah, I'm going to let you tell us about it.
This is a one-owner 1972 Cougar XR7. My cousin Diane here in the passenger seat is the original owner. I've been the caretaker of it for about 7 years now. And everything is original paint, interior, the top, everything. While it does show a little age, it has little dings here and there. We keep it as perfect as we can, and we are not going to restore it at all because we want to keep the integrity of the car alive. A 351 Cleveland.
Well, I really like it. And dear, you've done a nice job. You've been a great keeper of this thing.
Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a very special car to me.
Well, I can't say anything about a cougar and a cougar, but anyway, good to see you, dear. That was a layup. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to have to take a 364-day timeout to my next time I do this. Thank you so much, and thanks for being great sports. I love when people preserve things. That's awesome. All right, European sports car, 1974 to present, ESC3, Steve McCombs. And I really want to know what color this is. This is a Porsche 930 Turbo, folks. And if you know anything about the 930 Turbo, this is legendary. So, let's hear a little bit about this. And I also want to know what the unique color is. So tell us about this.
Well, I've been the owner and the caretaker of this car for 25 years. The color is a one of a one. It's called salmon red metallic with the white linen interior. It's all leather. And it's just been, it's all original, so it's never been repainted. Exactly, interior is exactly the same. But as said, the color is a special color. The car was in Porsche Parade in 2015. Dr. Wolfgang Porsche, who's the CEO of Porsche Cars Incorporated, loved the car, and I got him to sign his name in the right hand, left-hand corner of the hood underneath. So I have an 8.5 by 11 picture of him laying in my hood. So
that's the commitment from Porsche, ladies and gentlemen. That's what you're looking for in a car. But anyway, it's a really unique color, very cool. Are the wheels period correct as well? Were these factory?
No, the factory, the wheels are Porsche wheels, but they came off of a 93 model turbo car. So, but the original wheels did not make the car look, it didn't pop, because the centers, they were Fuchs wheels with anodizing rims, and the center was painted the same color as the car. So it just didn't pop.
I got it. Well, these are perfect for it, and I do like the look. And I'll tell you, it's interesting, the Fuchs wheels are making a tribute back. I saw a modern Porsche in lizard green, or but really bright green. I think it's Python green, they call it now. But beautiful with the Fuchs look wheels. So thank you for sharing it with us. Great to have you here. And you get a trophy. All right. All right, working our way down. We will have the best in show soon. There'll be a runoff. All right, we have in GT Touring, this is a 1974 to present. It's a 2012 Bentley Continental GTS owned by Brian and Betsy Davidson. Come on up. This is class and panache right here, folks. Hello, dear.
Hi.
How are you? I see you have your trophy husband with you.
Yes. This is the homecoming queen. Yes.
Don't stop.
Well, this is a Bentley 2012 GTC, and we've had it about 4 years. It has about 30,000 miles on it, And what most people look at this car and they say they can't believe the burled ash wood on it. So it's just a very unique and beautiful car. The steering wheel, the technician who built this car, it took him, what, a week and a half just to build the steering wheel. You know, they just don't make cars like this anymore.
It's also British labor, though. I'm just kidding. No, it's actually true craftsmanship. And if you guys have not seen the interior of this after they park it, you should look, because the wood really does pop and it makes it. And I love the color combo of the cream and white. Thank you for sharing it with us. All right. All right, I already gave you one. Okay. No, you don't get two trophies there. No, you don't win the whole thing yet. Yet. We'll think. All right. See you there. All right, next up. Super Car Performance 1974 to present. Ooh, 2009 Lamborghini Gallardo. This is an LP560. One of the original supercars and one of the things that really set a mark. All right. Tell us about this, young man.
I've only owned it for approximately 6 months. I'm from Australia. That's why I speak funny. So if nobody understands me, that's why. It was the original owner. Bought it in 2009. It's only just turned over 3,000 miles, and he had it for 12 years. Unfortunately, he wasn't able to drive it, and I bought it about 6 months ago. So yeah, just turned 3,000 miles. Very lucky. It's my dream.
Well, it's a great dream, and I'm glad you shared it with us. And you don't talk funny. I think you're actually having a good day. So here's your award. Thank you for playing along, audience. Okay, thank you. All right, well done. And in the AC2, this is American Car 2, 1955 to 1974. We have Charles Mullen and a 1970 AAR CUDA. Do we have that? Oh, I'm sorry, 59 Olds, excuse me. 59 Olds, and this is Charlie Mullen. I think the back end is gonna arrive anytime now when he pulls up. Charlie? Tell us about this car.
Well, it's a 5998 flat top. It has every single option. Factory air, power windows, power seat, six-way, Autronic Eye headlight dimmer. It's just every option, which is so rare.
Well, I love the color. So what is the accent color that also finds its way into the interior? What's that called?
Cardinal red.
Cardinal red. And you're a Cubs fan. No, I'm just kidding. I have no idea what your baseball affiliation is, but this is fantastic. And to see an Oldsmobile, for those of you who are younger, Oldsmobile was actually quite a brand back in the day. The Pitzes drove Oldsmobiles. My dad was an Oldsmobile Cutlass man. But this is just absolutely beautiful. And how long have you owned?
2 months. Florida. Came out of Miami, Florida, Dade County.
Well, it's beautiful, and I can see somebody rolling down the beach in this thing, because it is a showstopper, show stunner, and you can take a lot of your friends with you, too.
Including the trunk.
That's a Goodfellas reference. Okay, let me give you your trophy. One second. Gentlemen, can I have that trophy?
Dave, trophy.
They're really reluctant to give these up. They're very proud of them. How about a round of applause for our judging staff, by the way? Anybody you see in a yellow hat has been a judge, and they give up their time and effort. It is not easy to discern between these cars. Thank you so much. All right, it's time for best in show and penultimate. So we're going to bring up the two finalists, and we're going to talk to both owners, and then the judges are going to confer, and we're going to award penultimate, which will be basically runner-up, and then best in show. So we have two fantastic examples today to talk about. Ta-da. Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't like Corvettes in this color, we'll have to talk. Come on up in the Jag. All right, sir, I need a little information on this.
Well, it's a 1956 Corvette that was restored in 1990. When we bought it a year ago, it has 100 miles on it, and it was a museum piece. But we decided that good cars need to be driven, so we've put it currently has 440 miles on it, It appears exactly engine, body, etc., Cascade Gray, green, the way it came off the line.
It's absolutely stunning, and just the fit and the fitment and everything. And it's original, right? 400 miles. And what museum was it in?
It was in a gentleman that had 20 cars, an entrepreneur in Pennsylvania by the name of Clyde Horst. And he was an incredible entrepreneur, and he graduated high school, no college, so bought 25 1956s to celebrate his high school, and put them in a museum that he built. And we were fortunate enough a year ago to be able to acquire it from him.
Well, it's beautiful. Thank you for sharing it with us. And you're up for Best in Show. Congratulations. Hold on. And now to our other contestant in this category. I think I've seen this car before. All right, tell us more about the Jag again.
There we go. So this is my father's car. He bought it about 40 years ago. It's a 1938 Jaguar SS100.
Actually, I got in a bidding war to buy this with a pen from Japan. And when the guy that owned it got to where he thought was the correct price, or reasonable, he just ended the auction and said, I want it to stay in the U.S. and sold it to me. And I've had it ever since. It's been shown all over the country in various Jaguar and other concourses, Cincinnati, Lexington, Milwaukee, Hilton Head, places like that. And it always does pretty well. It's one of 108.
One of 108. Wow. And it's absolutely beautiful. I love the story about the bidding war, though, and he wanted to stay safe size. That's really incredible. Well, and it's good because so many vehicles do cross the pond. There's more, by the way, being imported because the 25-year rule now, we're starting to see other things come into the country, which I think is great that we didn't have the opportunity to see before. So two great cars. I'm going to let the judges confer. We'll be back in a minute. All right, our judges have made a decision, but I'd like them to introduce themselves a little bit. And first of all, how about a round of applause for Dave Renshaw, who's been a part of this team for, what, over 15 years, and our head judge. And Dave has said, I need to turn the reins over. So, Dave, I want you to say a few words and then introduce your new counterpart.
Yeah, last year was my 40th wedding anniversary, so I couldn't be here. And during the day, I'm looking at my watch. My wife says, you're thinking of Artomobilia, aren't you? I go, no, we'll give you that idea. But anyway, it's been, I actually have a 69 Z28 I restored. I won my class in 2010. But when I first attended Artomobilia, I like old Austin Healey's. I love Corvettes, Ferraris, Lamborghinis, the classics. And I'm not ever going to retire, but after 14 years, it's just time to kind of pass the torch. And I'm going to kind of serve as a, you know, consultant and just help out, help with the helter-skelter. So it is a lot of work. There's a lot of last minute stuff that has to be done, but hopefully you've enjoyed the show. But I've, thank you very much. And George and Brandon Billestein have decided that they would take over the role, and I'm gonna hand it over to George. His son, Brandon, is in a wedding, so he's actually on his way to a wedding in town, but here's George.
Thanks, Dave, and thanks for all you've done for the show. My name's George Billison. Billison. I've won here, I've lost here, I've judged here, I've done volunteer parking, that's how I started out. I enjoy the show. They always do an outstanding show here. And it's just fun. And I'm learning from Dave the head judging stuff. And it's a head spinner, so, but thank you very much.
How about a round of applause for just both gentlemen and all of our judges. Again, not easy, and I will tell you, this thing runs on volunteers. So if any of you have an interest, please reach out to John after the show. Give him about a week, week and a half to decompress. It's that guy over there, right there in the red. There's John Leonard. He is the director, has been for years. It takes a village to get this done and done right. So please volunteer, because otherwise it doesn't come off as well. All right, gentlemen, I'm going to let you announce, Dave. It's your job. This is the last one, bro. Here you go.
Okay, after a little bit of deliberation, a lot of deliberation, the best in show for this year's Artomobilia is the Jaguar. And the penultimate runner-up is this beautiful Corvette.
All right, the judges will get pictures with both cars. Gentlemen, thank you so much for bringing out. I mean, this is a hard decision, man. How do you know? And this is basically Dead Man's Curve, in a sense, the song. It was the Jaguar versus the Corvette. So. But all these guys are going home smiling because they got great awards and it was a great day. Thank you for coming. Thank you for being a part of the 17th annual Carmel Artomobilia. Thanks to all the volunteers. Have a great day. Be safe going home. Have a great one.